Hi everyone, welcome to the channel. Aries the Emperor here. Thank you guys for joining me on this beautiful morning, afternoon, evening, wherever you are watching. This is an All Aries channel for All Aries placements. Cross watchers are welcome as well. Please take in mind this reading may or may not resonate with everyone. So just take what does, leave what does not. Place the gender roles where they need to be for you. This is energy, and energy is all fluid, okay? Thank you guys. Everyone who has liked, subscribed, commented, donated, booked a personal reading with me. I will be sending readings out today periodically throughout the day, so make sure you're checking your email, as well as thank you guys to everyone and all of your beautiful comments yesterday. I won't be appearing on camera for every reading, but I just wanted to let you guys know that I do exist, okay? So let's jump into it. I kind of want to focus or continue to focus on the message at hand and how I can help you guys in any way, shape, or form here, as long as Spirit will allow me to, okay? Let's jump right on in. If you would like to connect with me, I'll leave my info in the description box regarding readings and the candle shop. All right, guys, we are entering Moon in Cancer, okay? Cancer is governed by the Moon itself. It also rules the stomach, the vagina, the breast, the ovaries. It is considered the mother figure of the zodiac, okay? And Capricorn, as we know, is the father. So just think feelings. When you think about Cancer, whether you want them or not, you could be in your feelings a little more than usual regarding a person, place, or thing that you are connected to or once was. And at the same time, there are others who may be thinking of you at this time. Maybe they're going through those feelings of the loss of you as well here. I would just advise, try and keep things light at this time. Okay, let's see what messages that Spirit has for you. Holy Spirit, angels, what messages do you have for the Aries collective spirit? Holy Spirit, angels, what messages do you have for the Aries collective? Eight of Pentacles, yeah. Keep things light at this time. You have the Lovers at the bottom of the deck. Like I said, this could be a time where you have others that are reminiscing about you and them together, like how you all work together, how you all fit together. If it's possible, if you guys can even come back together to work on something here. But I feel like what's most important overall is just focus on the relationships closest to you at this time. I definitely wouldn't stir up any I wouldn't dig up any buried bones in the backyard, so to speak, and try and make an artwork out of it at this time, especially if you know you guys are not compatible and this is friends and actual relationships, you know. Above all else, so if you can't love someone else, make sure you love yourself, okay? If you're not able to. Yeah, Four of Swords came out. Thank you, Spirit. But I really feel like someone is at peace with their self, with the decisions that they have made thus far in their life. Five of Swords, but somebody is not. Knight of Swords. Three of Cups is at the bottom of the deck. Cancer energy. Oh, wow. Okay, here we go. Did we not pull a Five of Swords yesterday in two readings? And this is a fourth deck. Wow. All right. So someone is not at peace about things not working out between the two of you. For some odd reason, it's that love-hate type of dynamic that I'm seeing here. The Knight of Swords is Gemini energy. This is somebody strategically wanting to speak their truth. And like I said, this is about feelings, Cancer energy, whether you want them or not. So beware. Beware, collective. I feel like you're at peace right now, so you may not be expecting this, or you may not even be aware that someone feels this way towards you. I feel like you're minding your business. Star card. This is healing, aligning yourself, aka minding your business, Aquarius energy. Six of Wands, okay? This is the focus being on you, celebrating yourself, aka minding your business, okay? And glowing up, might I add, and others around you noticing it. The Lovers, all right? And I mentioned earlier, someone is not at peace with the way things turned out. This is more Gemini energy here. This could have been a Gemini, or you could have Gemini aspected in your chart. Nine of Pentacles, like you are simply self-reliant at this point. Luxury is a thing that you are more focused on, I feel like, more than anything. And luxury could be whatever to you, okay? Luxury could be buying a higher thread count as far as your sheets go, and you feeling like $1 million, okay? But this Nine of Pentacles is self-made energy. And not only that, it comes from a good place. It comes from a humble place. It comes from a modest place. It comes from respecting yourself and loving yourself. And like I mentioned, others around you noticing that, okay? The Lovers, the Six of Wands, and the Nine of Pentacles here. But here's that negative energy, Ten of Swords, Gemini energy. Somebody is not happy that this is over and done with, and that you are celebrating, healing, elevating, and being glorified. Like somebody is definitely over it. And Ten of Swords came out in the reading yesterday as well. Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, something is fated for you to be on top. Even if you have hit rock bottom, you were not meant to stay there, or this is not a place where you're meant to be here. You've been granted the gift of resources. And definitely, I feel like you're being led here. Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles is resources coming together for a greater cause, for your success, the Wheel of Fortune. Look at this, this triangle. You see this? As long as you are continuing to give back, it will continue to circle around for you to continue to spin the Wheel of Fortune here and continuing to keep you in this Nine of Pentacles energy, regardless of what somebody else has planned for you. Three of Cups, it was at the bottom of the deck, Cancer energy. Queen of Wands, you are on fire, right? If not at this time, you are headed in that direction and it's evident, all right? Five of Wands we have here, which popped up in the last reading. Whatever energy this is, I feel like that is projecting in your direction. Then this negativity is just like I mentioned in the beginning. You know, somebody is sulking in their feelings about the past. And not only that, I mean, they could be focusing on trying to get back in your energy to try and rebuild a future. Because, I mean, I see a lot of conflict here. But this is someone who is going to have to put the work in themselves, because at this time, if you're moving with a heart of envy or a heart of jealousy, there's no way that you're going to be able to authentically pour into someone else. I feel like somebody is selfish and they only want to see things their way. It's just their way or the highway. And that's just not going to work for you. Like maybe you did choose the highway. You chose yourself and you chose to figure out how you, maybe you didn't always have the resources to get you to where you are or to get you to start building where you're going here. But you took a chance. You stepped out. You loved on yourself through it all. And I feel like it's paying off for you here. And whatever else tries to come up against you this time, it will not even Queen of Swords. It's not gonna work. Nothing is gonna get past you at this point here. All right, Spirit, give me one more card here to close out the message. Queen of Cups, you know, you're gonna kill them with kindness. This is Cancer energy. I feel like you're still nurturing, but at the same time, you know your boundaries, you know your self-worth. Thank you, Spirit, Empress energy. And there's no stopping you, all right? Once you take your seat on this throne with your banana and your glass, the day is done. You know, everything else falls to the wayside. And I love this, okay? So keep up the good high vibe energy. I'm gonna leave this reading here. Hit that like and subscribe button for more messages from me, and I'll catch you guys later. Ciao.